Hi, do your students struggle with graphing? Today we'll look at a distance versus time graph, and we won't use any numbers or rulers or graph paper. I wanted to show you that this process that I developed with my students and thought it might be helpful for you in your classroom. Hi, I'm Carolyn Balch, and I'm the author of Engaging Science Labs. So yeah, this is something that we did in our classroom. This is Galileo's, one of his ramp experiments. So you've got a ball rolling down a ramp and you're measuring where is the ball at specific pieces of time. So we use a metronome timer. And so this is starting at zero and then one, two, three. And you can see, since it's rolling down a ramp, that the amount of distance is getting greater and greater. And students can do this, but then it gets complicated for them to turn it into a graph. And so I came up with a way that was just fairly simple and straightforward and allows them to see the graph and to start learning how do we interpret graphs, because they're very pictorial and so helpful to understand, to help your understanding in what's going on in terms of this situation, what's going on if I can interpret this graph. So I've already pre-cut what we're gonna do here. I just wanted to show you, so this would be like the second tick of time, and that's the third, just so you're clear. This is the zero and the one, four, and then five, six, seven. Okay, so I just wanted you to get a sense of what's going on there. And then I've pre-measured these, but obviously students would do this as their part of their experiment and their procedure. So you're gonna measure between zero and one, and I'm gonna label that one, and then I'm just gonna stick it on the wall. Kids use the wall, the whiteboard, the door, any sort of clear, flat place that they can do. You could do it on the floor for sure. It's just, they can get pretty big. They can get like 6 feet, depending on how far, where you were driving your car, rolling the ball, how large that was. And I love them to do it sort of a one-to-one. So we start there with a graph, and then you can shrink it down, scale it down, and get a sense of what's going on with that. So that's one. And then this is where kids get a little confused. You always measure from zero. So how far did it go in two ticks of time? So I'm going to measure from the zero to the two. And then I'm going to put that on my graph. And here's three. And again, measuring from the zero to the three. And I think you're way ahead of me here. I can just start putting them up. Here's the four. It doesn't really matter how far apart I space is as long as it's even, because these are measuring even amounts of time. So the amount of time isn't as important as the fact as that the time is even. Okay, there's five, and that's six. And I think we can fit seven here. So there's our picture. It's a pretty clear, for most kids, it's a lovely direct correspondence from this. They can see, how did I get from here to here? What does this picture mean? This picture means this. Okay, and can you see that this is a curve? It's getting taller and taller and taller in the same amount of time. That has a special name, and we learned that. That's called a parabola. And we know, we can label our axes here. So this is time, this is distance. The amount, the unit, doesn't matter right now as long as it's a specific unit. And for us, the unit here was just how far it was, okay? And so the unit of time was the tick of time, and that was, again, even. Graphing is really difficult for a lot of students, and I think we somehow do them a disservice when we forget how difficult it is that we take this very concrete exercise that they did, and then we ask them to turn that into a number by measuring, and to put that, plot that number on a piece of graph paper. And so it's many steps removed from what they did. And so my goal is to, let's keep it as closely aligned to what we did as possible to see the graph. We can then take a picture of this. We could scale it down and plot it on a piece of graph paper. That's fine. But I just want them to see, again, that really strong connection from my data to my graph. And what does that look like? So I hope that's helped. I hope that's something you might want to try in your classroom. I'd love to hear if you do. And I'd also love to hear, you know, what are some solutions that you've come up with when graphing with your students. You can leave them in the comments below, and I'd be happy to respond to those. Thank you so much.
To find out more about curriculum and courses, check out my website at engagingsciencelabs.com.